Hello and good day to you. Today's video is going to be on design and aid, popularly known as DAK. I'll be using version 8 of the software. We'll be taking the tension gauge we did in the previous video and we'll be putting it into design and aid to style a sweater or a child. Locate your software, design and aid, click on it, and a window pops up. Click on Standard Garment Styling, New Garment. The gender is going to be female and it's going to be a child. It's going to be for a child, the age group. And the garment style, sweater, the top, sleeve, it's going to be set in, the front neck, V, and the back neck is going to be straight. When you're done, click OK. Select the knitting machine icon if you have the complete version of design and aid, then click OK. Here you have to locate the knitting machine you'll be using. Since I'm using the LK150 of 150 needle bed, it's already selected and I'll just click OK. This is where we'll be putting in our tension gauge. If you remember, our tension was 17 cm for 40 stitches, so I'll put in 17 here. And the height of 60 rows was 19 centimeters. I'll do the same for the welt cuff and neckband tension. Here you can put your note or you leave it. I'll just put in stitch 3. LK150. And also this you can write notes as you desire. I'll say multi-weld, plain bodies. Then when you're done, click OK. I'll be knitting with the classic body ease. You can go casual, oversized, zero, but I'll just go classic, but I want it to fit. Click OK. Then standard size. We'll be using the 57 chest waist of 54 centimeters and hip of 60 centimeters with a height of 104 centimeters, which is 41 inches. Click OK. Here, as this window pops, you can make any adjustment you desire. If you want the length to be longer, you can change it as you desire. Or you can use, here you can still fill in your standard size for the person you want to make your garment. And if you notice, as I click on each, you see this icon here, it changes. It tells you how to measure to. And so, you see, just click on them if you want to change for the person you're measuring for or the person you're knitting for. Click OK. So, these other icons here, you can make alterations to your garment. This one is for the neckband welt, neck width, you see it? It clicks to show you what to do, where you are applying changes to. You can click the other one, when you finish you click OK, but since I'm not going to change anyone, I'll just go and say File, Save As. I want to save it in a folder of choice, so I'll go to my software and change and save it in a folder of choice. As I said, I'll save it in this design and aid video. I already have one 7 cm. I'll just put 7 cm A here to remind me, or I'll just write Annie here. Okay, I'll save. Then, next you can print. Now, let's take the back of it and you're going to click on garment text, click on it. Then next, take a preview and see how, if you like it. The window pops up. Yes, tells you that where is your carriage going to be. Are you starting on the right side or the left side? My carriage is going to be on the right. So that's why I picked. If it's going to be on the left, you take the left, but mine is going to be on the right. Are you using hand knitting or machine knitting? I'll be using machine. And is the wrong side going to face you? Yes, it's going to face me. So you can click, and after that, you click OK. And you see it on your screen. Here it shows on your screen. If you notice, on row 70, before we knit row 70, we are going to decrease 5 stitches at left, or on the left, and 5 stitches on the before row 71. We'll be decreasing 5 stitches on the right or at right. But apart from that, okay, if you wonder why my name got in on that, you click this symbol and you can alter your name. Let me write an email there and click OK. When you click preview, everything is checked. You see that my name is changed also there. But if you don't want to print, to knit from a print, you can also go to your interactive knitting screen. If you click on that icon, a window pops up. You locate your file from this browse shape file. So you locate it. You see it there, 57 female anino. And you click OK. Let's take it from this time around and click OK. And if you click this traffic sign, this traffic light, sorry, it tells you what to do, that you're going to cast on left needle to 36 and to right needle 36, and you're going to need 9 rows of well. That is going to give us 3 centimeters. But if I'm knitting on using a mockery for my well, that means I'll be timesing this 9 rows by 2, making it I'll be knitting 18 rows of well. And when you're ready, you click OK. I'm not going to use the magnetic switch link, but if you have it, you can use it. I have not used it before on my LK150, but I've used it on the Silvery SK280 and also on my Electronic KH950i. After that, then if you don't have that, you can use the arrows on your keyboard to make movements. You move up and you move down using the arrows on your keyboard. So, and that's all about when you get here, it tells you, before I round up, it tells you what else to do. You see, it can speak to you when to decrease if you activate this mouse icon for it to speak to you, and it can make sounds when you activate this other sound icon. If you activate it, it tells you it beeps whenever it's time for a decrease or an action to be made or a change made. You can activate the bell too, and also you can activate the eye icon. So let's do that and come back. You see, but when you activate all of them, we do it. It just beeps. I don't want the beep. I prefer it speaking to me, right? Okay. This one alerts me that this is happening. So hope you enjoy this video, and the next video will be knitting this garment we designed, and also then I'll give you a link to my website, then it will be up. I'll give you a link to it where you can download the pattern and warn it together. Also, you can subscribe. You can also subscribe so that you don't miss any of my video, or you know when it's coming out. You know, we tend to forget names. And hope you have a lovely day. Remain blessed.